skipped me, man. You allowed it. You allowed it.
Dear Michael, I can't wait to be your wife. You're my best friend, and I can't think of a better way to spend my Saturday than to pledge my love and undying affection for you. I know things aren't always perfect, but even in the midst of turmoil, I find that the best place to be is with you. You always make things better. There's first generation cousins, there's second generation cousins, and then there's third generation cousins. Family, that's my friends, and friends that I love like family.
Not only does this woman love me, but she takes care of me. She's there to nurture and make sure I'm, you know, on my feet. It showed me that I had somebody on my team who was willing to be there for me no matter what.
Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not jealous or boastful. It is not arrogant or rude. Love does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in right. Love bears all things, love believes all things, love hopes all things, and love endures all things. Love never fails.
Once we got that taste of our chemistry as one, there was no turning back. I knew it. I was assured very early on that I may have found the one for me, and there was nothing I could do about it. Nervous, happy, excited, can't wait to spend the rest of my life with the woman I love.
After today, I look forward to growing old with Michael, having kids, having grandkids, and just enjoying life. He's not a crier. I've never seen him cry in the 6 years we've been together. I hope he cries. I really do.
The Bible teaches that marriage is to be a permanent relationship of one man and one woman, freely and totally committed to each other. Our Lord declared that man shall leave his mother and father and cleave or unite with his wife, and they two shall become one flesh.
He's my best friend. He rationalizes the irrational. He loves me more than I love myself sometimes, and when we're together, I really don't think about anything or anyone else.
Tracy Rochelle Alberry, Michael Timothy Bostic, with this ring, I pledge my love and my life to you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. According to the word of God, I now declare you husband and wife. Michael, you may salute your bride.
Today begins our happily ever after. When we first began this adventure, I don't think either one of us expected to be where we are today. I love your smile. I love your laugh. I love your compassion. I love the way you make me feel like no one else matters in this world but us. I love everything about you, and I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you.
Just 6 short years ago, two strangers started off as friends, just kicking it. Who would have thought that friendship would have blossomed into love? Well, I did. Early evening conversations turned into late night explorations of each other's minds and hearts. It just wasn't the usual type of discussions. It felt right.
We went to a sushi restaurant. I had purple hair. He was surprised. Then we just talked till 1 a.m. and we both had to go to work the next day.
One, two, and three. There you go. They're all lucky young ladies.
He makes sure that if something hurts on me, I feel like it hurts on him too. If somebody bothered me, then he goes and tries to fix whoever bothered me, and he's like my knight in shining armor.
Looking back at the last 6 short years and forward to eternity, I hope and pray that God bless us with a fruitful and prosperous union. Now that our friendship has grown into love, our love into a romantic relationship, and our relationship into a marriage, I'm confidently assured that there is no one else I'd rather accompany me on this beautiful journey of life but you. I love you with all of my heart, and I'm happy that God chose you for me. Sincerely, Michael Timothy Boston.